Edmonton Oilers in action tonight. Let's start with them tonight, Quinn.
Thanks, Quinn. You're being so helpful. As per usual. It's a good inside joke. All right. The Edmonton Oilers probably have a bitter taste in their mouths thinking about today's opponent, the New York Islanders. The Oil got beat 8-1 in Brooklyn earlier this month. Now the home team hoping to snap a 7-game losing streak in the second and final meeting between these two teams this season. The Islanders with the top chance in the first period. Kuhlman lets one go. Cam Talbot just doesn't see it. It rings hard off the post. That got a lot of iron. Second period, Kyle Okposo going to the net. He's on top of the rebound, but Talbot makes a big save, getting across and getting the toe in front of it. Then under a minute after that, he has to come up huge on Josh Bailey, who gets a quick shot from the slot. Talbot kicks the pad out. We talked to Doug Waite yesterday. He was honored during the second period. Love playing in Edmonton. Touches the heart there. I touched my microphone as well. Now this is not ideal. Adam Clendenning is going to take a shot up high. Goes down, but the play continues. Casey Cizikas is all over the loose puck and scores his 7th of the season. Clendenning would return to the game, though. To the third we go. Still 1-0 Isles. Anton Lander going to turn and shoot. That's a great idea because you know what? That's his first goal in, get this, 65 games. He's got to be feeling good. Tie game. It's not even a minute later. Yaroslav Halak can't find the puck. Leon Draisaitl spots it in the crease. That's number 16 on the season for the center, and it gives the Oilers the 2-1 lead. Lots of time left for the Islanders, though, who need a big 2 points. And Anders Lee tests Talbot, but the Oilers' keeper has been playing so well, and he keeps that out. Now watch the top of your screen. Oilers penalty kill, and Benoit Pouliot is taken out by Lee, goes down awkwardly into the boards. He was in a lot of pain. You'll see him there. He kind of toughs it out for most of his shift. That looks to be his shoulder. He left the game and didn't return. That was bad news for the Oilers, but here's some good news. Brandon Davidson, the one-timer, and he gives his team a 2-goal lead. That would be enough. The Oilers snap that 7-game losing streak with a 3-1 win. Cam Talbot has been outstanding, makes 36 saves tonight, and has stopped 102 of the last 107 shots he's faced. All right, so this was this morning. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins skated with his team for the first time today since getting hurt. He hasn't played since January 18th against Florida when he blocked a shot with his right hand. The forward required surgery and some screws around the knuckle. That was really beat up. He says he's week to week. So much talk after that about players blocking shots, and it's something he'll think about now.
A lot of the times I'll go out with open palms, and they say that's kind of how you gotta get hurt. So I thought about that, closed my palm, and of course it happens like that. So I think it just kind of hit me in the perfect spot. Not so perfect, but in the right spot to break it.
And as we also know, today was the Oilers' first practicing game after losing three teammates, Teddy Purcell, Justin Schultz, and netminder Anders Nielsen. A lot of talk about Schultz, his struggles, and the fans' boos, of course. His former team thinks it was all about his confidence.
Belief system's really important for players. They feel when people believe in them or don't believe in them, and that can range from teammates to a coaching staff to an organization, even to the fans. And when you know somebody believes in you, you have a better chance at success. And, you know, I take full responsibility as a coach for this season. The belief system dwindled a little bit with Justin, and I'm sure that affected him.